Welcome to another tutorial on real-time data in MS Excel. Previously, we learned to build add-ins in VBA, to display real-time information, in MS Excel. Today, we will learn to use Python, to display real-time information in MS Excel. We will use the real-time data server technology. You can create RTD servers, using visualstudio.net as well. Then, you can use MS Excel's RTD function, to retrieve information in real time. We, however, will use Python, and create our own functions, to access information in real time. RTD servers are used to access information such as stock market, in real time. However, for the purpose of learning, we will use our CPU and RAM usage information. Let's start. First, we will download and install a Python library, which will integrate Excel with Python. It seems that the library is already available in our system. Now we will just install it in our Excel as well. This will install an add-in to our MS Excel application. This add-in will make Python files accessible from MS Excel. It will also add a toolbar to the ribbon for various settings. We will make sure that the add-in is properly installed using the add-ins window. The availability of toolbar is also evidence that the add-in is installed and working properly. Then, to test the system, we will create a text file and copy a sample code from the website of library we are using. Let's copy this code and paste it in the text file. You can write code using Notepad, but a code editor is always recommended. Now we will save this file here and rename it to something appropriate, like the name of our Python function. We will copy the path where our Python code file resides to the Python path text box in the toolbar and add the name of the Python code function to the load module text box. Then we will restart the Excel file. Now we can use our Python function in MS Excel, just like any other Excel function. This function generates current date and time. Let's properly format the date and time, and include seconds as well. We can use a custom format in the Format Cells window. In the custom format, we will add year, month, day, hour, minutes, and seconds to our data type, and press OK. Now, as you can see, the current date and time is being retrieved from Python and automatically updating. This means everything is working fine. Now, we can create another Python code file here. Just like before, we will create a text file with py extension. Then we will open this file in a text editor and add some Python codes. You can use Notepad, but it is recommended to use a code editor. This first line of code we are going to add will import all the necessary libraries that we are going to use in our RTD server. Then we will create a function that we will call from Excel. This function will require two parameters as well. First parameter will define the update frequency in seconds. A value of 1 means the server will update every second. The second parameter will tell which value to return, as the function will generate multiple values. Then there is a while loop. While true means the loop will never end on its own, and will keep running in the background. This code will generate current date and time, and will store it in a variable. Then we will read current CPU usage from system. Then we will get the memory information from system. Here we will retrieve total memory from memory information, and memory being used currently by the system. Both values are divided by those numbers to convert them to gigabytes. Now, if the second parameter is 0, the value of current date and time will be returned. CPU percentage, if the value is 1. Total memory, if the parameter value is 2. And memory used, if the value is 3. Finally, we will add a delay to our loop, using the value from first parameter. Our code is complete. Now, we will save the file. We will create an Excel file, to create a nice dashboard, based on this real-time information. In the load module text box, we will add the function name. And restart the Excel file. Since we used Notepad to write our code, our Python compiler will give some errors, due to bad indenting. We can fix this by editing our file, in a proper code editor. Open the Python code file, in a code editor. We will use the Visual Studio code editor. Here we will make corrections to all the indenting and spacing. Python works on spaces. If a space is wrong, the code will not work properly. In Notepad, we don't have the actual idea of indents and spaces. Now it looks fine. Let's try again. We will open MS Excel now, and if there is no error, we will use the function we created to retrieve real-time information. Let's get the current date and time first. We will enter 2 in the first parameter, making the server update every 2 seconds. Now we will format the date and time properly using the Format Cells window. Then we will get the CPU performance. The total performance of a CPU is always 100. Then we will get the current CPU usage from Python server, using value 1 in second parameter. We will update this information per second, by entering 1 in first parameter. The free CPU performance is always the difference of 100%, and the current CPU usage. Now we will retrieve the memory information. First we will get the total memory. Then we will get the memory currently being used by the system. The difference is the free memory available. We will properly format these values, using the comma button. We will also hide the grid lines. Then we will add some bars using conditional formatting, to display CPU and memory usage. We can also add a chart, based on this information, such as memory usage. Our data is updating perfectly in MS Excel. We can change the layout and make it more appealing, and also display CPU usage instead of memory, in our pie chart. And with this, we end our tutorial. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.